As an FBI agent, Steve Moore helped take down an Al-Qaeda cell that bombed the U.S. consulate in Karachi. He helped ID a suicide bomber and track down terrorists who blew up a hotel in Indonesia. Moore interrogated the man who shot up a Jewish daycare in L.A., and he got a confession. In short, for 25 years, Steve Moore's job was going after killers and getting convictions.
Former FBI agent Steve Moore joins us now. So they're saying there actually is DNA evidence.
No, there is not DNA evidence. What they're saying is that whoever killed Meredith cleaned up in Amanda's bathroom. That's all they're saying. And they're assuming that the person who cleaned up had to be Amanda.
They did find traces of her material there.
You mean in her own bathroom? They found Amanda's DNA in her own bathroom? Astounding.
So you say that piece of evidence, this is the strongest piece of evidence in their case, you say that's not convincing.
That's ridiculous.
And thank you, Mr. Moore, for your service to our country, which has been extraordinary.
I would like to take a few moments and peel off the polite diplomatic veneer of what is going on in Bolivia right now. There is no judicial procedure going on here. This is a state-sponsored kidnapping.
With an American stuck inside a Nicaraguan prison. In 2010, police arrested an American man, Jason Porrical, accusing him of money laundering and drug trafficking. He was convicted even though there was really no evidence to back up the charges. Former FBI agent Steve Moore has studied this case on his own and says that Jason Porrical could have been targeted by authorities because he's a wealthy American.
They claimed he had all this money in the bank accounts. Okay, fine. But Jason called witnesses to show that this is my money. I am a witness. That's my money in an escrow account to buy this property. The judge declared that inadmissible.
The prosecution was also unable to prove any money had changed hands between Porrical and the other 10 accused traffickers, who told the judge they never even met Jason.
All that's happening is the prosecutor and the investigators are saying, there's money laundering going on here. This guy did it. You're going to have to take our word for it. Not going to be a limit to what they were going to do. Some of the weapons I saw the AK-47, I saw they also had a MAC, either a 10 or 11. These people were armed for bear. Fortunately, you know, having a gun doesn't make you able to shoot it any more than having a violin lets you know how to play it.
No way out, an American man living a nightmare, jailed without charges in a South American prison that's one of the toughest and strangest on earth.
He's got to start paying them money.
Steve Moore is a retired FBI agent. He advocated for the release of Amanda Knox, and he's investigated Jacob's case for free.
Here we are in front of the Palace of Justice. Is this a place of hope for Jacob Ostrich?
No. The Palace of Justice is a misnomer. There should be an ATM in the lobby. It should have a "We Take Credit Cards" sign on the front.
What's really happening, according to Moore and others on Jacob's defense team, is an old-fashioned shakedown. Bolivian officials are demanding money.
Here's a guy they see coming in from New York who's got probably a lot of liquid cash, and they saw an opportunity.
Steve, can you just give us a sense of the state of mind of the family? You were there right by their side when they walked into court this morning.
Robin, they're being brave, they're being strong. There's really nothing else they can do. Home invaders have a reason for being there. They either want money, they want sex, they want something. If this home invader came in, he was just a thrill killer. It was like Clockwork Orange or something. This makes no sense.
What is the thing that you guys, you prosecutors, say about confessions?
The bad joke is you can always, I can convict anyone. It's just the innocent take a little bit more time.
The screams of the kids would wake him up. Sometimes the screams of the kids would wake me up too. You think about it, you dream about it, and you can't let it go until you feel you've done right by the victims.
As a 25-year veteran of the FBI, familiar with the judicial processes overseas and in the United States, I testify here under oath that the imprisonment of Jacob Ostreicher appears by any reasonable standard to be wrongful. I call upon the President and the State Department to act responsibly according to Title 22 of the United States Code. Thank you.
Mr. Moore, thank you so very much, especially, you know, I think your point in citing Title 22, we will convey that to the President and to the Secretary of State in the hopes that they will act.